By the mid-1970s, the MiG-23BN, with its chopped nose line giving better pilot visibility, was in service. This led to an even more extensively modified version dedicated exclusively to ground attack. It was called the MiG-27. It was basically the same airframe as the MiG-23, but the pilot's field of view was better and there was more armor around the cockpit. It was fitted out to carry air-to-ground rather than air-to-air weapons. In a ground attack aircraft, extreme speed is not necessary. Most of the mission is carried out at transonic speeds and low altitude. The MiG-27 was the first Mikoyan aircraft with a digital weapons control system. The MiG-23's radar was replaced with a laser rangefinder and illuminator for laser-guided missiles and rockets. The MiG-27K also had a TV search and track system. Around 850 MiG-27s were built. The 27M is still being produced in India under license by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. In the 1970s, the MiG-27 was designed to carry smart munitions. The American experience with such weapons in the Gulf War has reinforced the Russian Air Force's interest in this approach, and the MiG-27 is likely to have a long service future. One MiG-27 pilot says the digital weapon system is so smart that if you placed an officer's hat on the ground, he could hit it from many kilometers away. The digital weapon system is also designed to operate against ground air defenses. The aircraft carries anti-radar missiles which home in on any radar that locks onto it from the ground. The anti-radar missiles are fast enough to destroy the radar before the surface-to-air missile reaches the aircraft. The MiG-23 and its descendants have accumulated a service life of more than 20 years. The MiG-23 is no longer the mainstay of the Soviet fighter force, and variable geometry aircraft have been superseded by advances in aircraft design. But the swing-wing silhouette of the MiG-27 will be visible in Russian skies well into the next century.